the majestic nighttime skyline of Dallas, Texas. Downtown as busy and bustling as ever. It's the Los Angeles Clippers facing the Dallas Mavericks. Hi, everyone. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. Going to bring you the NBA right here on 2K Sports. Now a chance to check out our starting lineups. Premier performer we'll see tonight, Monte Ellis. He always comes to play.
Well, Ellis is one of the most acrobatic finishers in the NBA, Kevin. His ability to race in from the perimeter and score, either in transition or against a half-court defense. He finds his way to the rim, and he can finish once he gets there.
And he's shown the ability of absorbing contact, hanging, and still finishing. I think he could even stand to be more aggressive looking for contact, Steve, just to up those free throw attempts, but regardless, a devastating score around the rim. Hey, you really can't say the Mavericks were a bad team last year. They were just a little below par compared to what we've been accustomed to. They just were not nearly as deadly offensively, and that's always a recipe for struggles in the West.
Now Griffin inside. Redick inside the line, and the jumper is on the mark. And for the Mavs against the rest of the West, as you were just talking about, Clark, they went 24-28 against the rest of the conference, and while that is all right, Steve, it's not going to get you into the playoffs.
Not with the depth of this conference, Kevin, and I think you have to be at least 500 this year against the West to get in. The Mavs know this, and they've been a perennial playoff team for a long time. They just couldn't quite get everything together last season.
Shoots it up. Good, and Paul gets the assist.
Pretty passing. Timely recognition as to where the open man was.
Out of bounds, the Clippers take possession.
Such a careless pass. You've got to keep your head in the game here.
For Los Angeles, they've gone 2-3 here to start out the game. About 1 minute into the first quarter. Jordan kicks to Griffin. Solid play in the low block, and that one's good. Griffin's got his first 2 points.
Yeah, 3 out of 4 from the floor, so a good start for this club.
He feeds it to Ellis. Calderon kicks to Ellis. They get a hand on it, and that's out of bounds. Dallas will retain possession. And so it's Dallas with it. 6-point game. A 3-pointer, no good.
Tough 3-point try there with a hand in his face.
Boy, you'd be lucky to make that one against great defense.
And then Griffin with the dunk.
Phenomenal alley-oop slam right there, guys.
They're taking advantage, Clark, of a team that looks lost out there.
Yeah, this is threatening to get kind of ugly out here.
Little over a minute 30 into this first quarter.
Well, I'm sure Chris Paul is not happy with how last season ended. He's hungry for a title. But a franchise best in wins for the Clippers, and for CP3, another great season statistically, I think he's got to take some solace in that.
The lead pushed to double digits. Redick's got 7.
And the shots continue to fall as they try to put this thing away.
Yeah, big run here, and they've got their opponents in the rearview mirror.
And Dallas calls their first timeout of the game. And for Chris Paul, last season, a career low in minutes with a great backup behind him and Eric Bledsoe.
Yeah, even when Paul missed those 12 games with an injury, the Clippers did fine without him. But now Bledsoe is on to Phoenix after the trade. Darren Collison steps into that backup role, and we'll see how he's able to fare.
Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Kevin, Doc Rivers was just addressing the plan with his team. He wants this game played at breakneck pace as much as possible. He was very clear, saying the fast break is going to be our best friend today. Guys, we'll just have to watch how it plays out here in the first half. Kevin, back to you.
Thank you, Doris. Now here's Ellis. The shot's good on the assist by Calderon.
Hasn't been able to get it going offensively. It's been a slow start for him.
against Calderon. Passes it to Redick. Three-pointer. And another three for the Clippers.
Well, once a shooter, always a shooter. J.J. Redick, one of the great marksmen of all time at Duke in the college game. And it's kept on rolling here in the NBA. He's got deep range on his three. Can spot up and shoot from anywhere. And also put the ball on the floor a couple times and create a shot inside.
Great shot is right. And like you said, not only threes, but Steve, any shot where you give Redick a chance to set his feet and get a clear view of the hoop. His shot form is just too consistent for him to miss. He is one of those players who works on that just so diligently. You know he's going to find a degree of success every time out there. Here's Ellis, following the basket by Blake Griffin. That one's good, and the Clipper lead is cut down now to just 11 on the bucket from Arian.
Excellent work offensively to get that shot attempt into a can't-miss area.
Paul with the ball, now defended by Calderon. The drive by Paul. And boy, that looked like goaltending. Yes, it is. And so they will award the basket there.
Defensively, this team is just giving up way too many open looks.
You're exactly right. And to battle back, they've got to shore that defense up, Steve.
Mavericks making a switch here. Carter's checked in. Dallas is gone. 1-3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. Ball's knocked loose. Dudley, the pass to Paul. Now the dish to Redick. And here we go. The Mavericks in a fast break. Arian's got the ball. Here's Carter. And a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
Boy, extremely opportunistic defense leading to those points there.
That dunk clock coming within seconds of the steal.
Love the way they convert from defense to offense.
But that's what happens when you get all five guys on a string defensively ready to react and make a play.
And so here are the Clippers following the score by Dallas. Paul gets a screen from Griffin. Pass to Dudley. Dives for it. And here we go. Calderon defended by Paul. Here's Ellis, and Jordan sends it back out to Marion. This one for three. Can't get it to go. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Dishes it to Dudley. To Paul. Paul left side, and he gets it to go. Paul's got his second basket. And what's your take, guys, on the hustle stats for the Clippers?
You know, they've done a great job of getting a hand up on shooters. Actually have gotten a lot of blocks as well, solidifying that defensive effort.
Something else I've liked out of this team today is how they've pressured the ball handler, really forcing turnovers.
And the Clippers making a switch here. Trail by 13. Ellis outside. Harris. Crowder kicks to Harris. Dallas moving it around. And stolen by Barnes. From deep. On the wing, Ellis. Smooth as silk on the finger roll. Ellis has got 5 points so far.
A little touch of class there, guys. The end of that play with the finger roll.
Harris against Paul. Redick. Outside for Griffin and taken away by Ellis. Right dishes to Ellis. Ellis off a pick from Crowder. And Monte Ellis again. 7 points in the game.
Really aggressive play, taking it to the rim against the big man.
Tell you what, I love that fearless attitude.
Paul passes to Redick. Off target from three-point range. 6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. And it's Carter missing.
Man, that's too bad. Easy shot there, and he's got to knock that one down.
Well, that's a concentration cramp right there. I mean, just lost focus.
Jamal Crawford, he's checked in for the Clippers. The three from Barnes. It's rebounded by Dallas. Knocked away. And the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
They've built a big lead here early.
Both defensively and offensively. They've been terrific right from the tip.
Here's Harris. No good on the buzzer beater. and a double-digit lead on the scoreboard as we end the first quarter of play. Clipper